Seriously? Hey everyone, Dante D here, and welcome to the channel where we talk about comic books and other geek stuff. For those of you that have been watching the channel for a while, you're probably aware that I haven't been actively reading any new comic books for a while. So I kind of took a peek at what Marvel and DC are doing right now, and boy, was that a mistake. Now, around the time I stopped buying new comics, that's when Marvel was actually starting with their new direction and with including a lot of political rhetoric in their comic books, and I just was not interested. I did not like it, and a lot of people that watch this channel too also are not a fan of it. I'd hoped by now it would stop, but clearly it has not. Holy heck, if anything, it's getting worse. Why? So after seeing this, I can say with great certainty, I really miss Rob Liefeld. Well, maybe not Liefeld in particular, but honestly, 90s comics need to make a comeback. Why? Because 90s comics are badass. I bet all the collectors out there who trash talk 90s comics are now taking a look at them and regarding them as sacred as Action Comics number one. Like, especially when you're considering the kind of stuff that Marvel and DC are putting out nowadays. So you said that Rob Liefeld was a terrible artist and he can't draw any feet. I actually would agree with that statement, but if you compare the content that Rob Liefeld was drawing and putting out there to what's being drawn and put out nowadays, I think Rob Liefeld takes the cake. I realize today's video is either going to tick off a lot of people or make a lot of people happy. And as a subscriber to the channel named Eric Breen once said, this is a topic that has been beaten to death, resurrected, and beaten again. But it just needs to be said. Why? So the image that you're looking at right now is an image of the New Warriors. Now, the New Warriors was a superhero team of younger superheroes that debuted in the 1990s, and when they came out, they were pretty bad looking, like really bad. They were all swole, they looked really good, they looked like they worked out. And now, many years later, we get the New Warriors, and this is what we get. The art style is completely different than the original New Warriors. I get it, art styles have to evolve over time, but this new art style is very juvenile, and look how they are drawing these characters. Not to mention, their names are ridiculous, and so are their costumes and their powers. I was really happy to hear that this got canceled, but I still can't get over the names. And I'm sorry if this is old news. I know this has been around for a while, but I'm just learning about this now because I've been ignoring Marvel pretty much, and DC, anything new really. We have Snowflake, Safe Space, Trailblazer? What is up with Trailblazer? Like, she's quite overweight, and that's not what you would expect a superhero to look like. So are they doing this on purpose now? And she has a magical backpack. She has a magical backpack. I literally could take that idea to my six-year-old daughter and present that to her, and she would probably even think that was lame. The only person I know who has a magical backpack now that I think of it is...
You have to say backpack. Say backpack! Say backpack! Backpack, backpack.
And now that I think of it, she actually looks like an adult version of Dora who ate too much. Also, let's think about who buys comic books. I don't know a lot of kids that are between the ages of like 12 and like 17 that actually go out and buy comic books. Most comic book readers are between the ages of like 25 and like 50. Younger generations, for the most part, do not seem interested in comic books. The comic book industry is pretty much supported by people who grew up with comic books. People like myself and yourself. It is as if Marvel and DC are just poking at fans and trying to get them even more up in arms about what they're putting out. If this kind of stuff were working, I would understand why they're putting it out. However, it's not. I have many viewers that actually openly speak out against this type of content, and I'm talking particularly about my boy Biggs, Shout out to you, Biggs. He absolutely hates this kind of stuff and openly speaks out about it, not only on the channel, but also in comic book shops. He was actually telling me about an argument he got in with someone at a comic book store over this type of content. Biggs doesn't like this stuff. He's more of a Black fan. So that's why today I'm telling you, yeah, I miss Rob Liefeld. He may not be the best artist, but I definitely prefer this type of content to this type of content. What comic book companies today do not understand is that superheroes are fantasy. They're not supposed to look real. They're not supposed to look realistic. I know there have been many people in the past who've spoken out against the unrealistic representation of comic book characters. Do you want to sell books or not sell books? Comic books should not be the medium to enact social change. If you want to do that, get into politics. Give this video a like and let me know in the comments if you miss 90s comics as well and you want 90s style, bloody, angry content to just come back. Honestly, after seeing this, I had to pull this beauty out just to reset my mind. The 90s did put out some content that was not the greatest. However, I found the art to be pretty much stellar. I really enjoyed the aggressive styles that were in comic books at the time. The boom that was going on in comic books in the 1990s was pretty much unprecedented. Yes, that was due in part to a speculator's bubble, but companies knew what was selling at the time, and the numbers definitely showed it. Now, had these companies not gotten greedy, the comic book market probably wouldn't have crashed, or at least could have been a little bit more sustainable than it was after 1994. But that's another topic in and of itself. Art is just getting progressively more juvenile and progressively more childish. Comics are not for kids anymore. They were at one time, but it's mostly adults who are reading comic books. People should be aspiring to be more like superheroes, not make superheroes look more like regular people.
The superhero celebrates humanity. It's what we all aspire to be, and it gives us hope that we can be that.
This is a great quote because I feel that this captures the spirit of what a superhero should be. I learned a lot of concepts of good and bad from comic books. I started working out because I wanted to look like some of my favorite superheroes. Superheroes should be instilling in people the desire to be better, to be the best that they can. I'm sorry, you can't do that with characters that look like this. These characters are pretty much saying you're fine the way you are. And that to me is probably going to foster a generation of people who are just happy the way they are and never strive to better themselves and to be better. Now, don't get me wrong, I'm not saying because of comic books that the future generations are hopeless, but what I am saying is the type of message that this is delivering is not helping at all. I think people that are from a diverse background or are LGBTQ probably would find this type of content offensive. There is a lot of diversity on this channel. I have people from all over who comment and engage in conversations with me, and even they tell me that they do not like this type of content. Marvel, DC, please get a clue